Hi, welcome back to the channel. My name is Molly, and today at Live UTI Free, we're chatting with Dr. Mandy about treating recurrent UTIs. If you're new to our channel, be sure to check out the description below as we've linked to other resources that you might find helpful. Lastly, if you enjoy these videos, think they're important, and want to support what we do, be sure to hit subscribe and tick the bell so you get notified when we post new videos. And other than that, we hope these videos provide the insights you need to take the next step on your UTI recovery journey. So, welcome Dr. Mandy to our Clinician Insights series, and thank you for taking the time to talk to us about recurrent and chronic UTIs.
Thank you for having me today.
Thank you. So, firstly, for our community, can you tell us a bit about yourself, where you're based, and what led you to treating patients with recurrent UTIs?
Yes, absolutely. So my name is Dr. Mandy, and I'm a doctor in clinical nutrition, a licensed nutritionist and a certified nutrition specialist and a functional diagnostic nutrition practitioner. And I also am a professor. I teach biology and nutritional biochemistry in various different colleges. So I am based in North Carolina. And I founded IC Healer after my 10-year battle with debilitating bladder conditions, which started first as IC, interstitial cystitis, and then quickly turned into chronic UTIs. I was diagnosed about 2008 when my daughter, after my daughter was born. And honestly, it was the same thing, not a lot of solutions outside of conventional treatments. And I really didn't want to do the conventional treatments. There were a lot of them were very invasive. But my symptoms got worse over time, year after year. And then I decided that I'm just going to pursue a career change. And that's when I went to pursue my master's and then my doctorate. And I, during that process is when I started to really dig a little deeper into my own root causes. So I learned about what my root cause was, and then I started to use my experience to help other people suffering from the same thing.
No, that's amazing. And the fact that you've gone through that experience and then you can use that to help others, that's really great.
Thank you.
So, what type of testing do you utilize when investigating recurrent UTIs, and in what situations do you do so?
So, because of the nature of my scope of practice, the tests I do revolve around biochemistry and nutritional biochemistry. So, I just want to clarify a few things. I think when people hear the word nutritionist, there's a lot of misconceptions. I'm a clinical nutritionist, I'm a doctorate, and the level I work that I do is very high level, almost like a naturopath. So, you can kind of compare me to a naturopath. And so, what a lot, so just before I get into the test, I want people to understand that. And your listeners may not understand this, so it's good to clarify that you have enzymes in your body and they rely on vitamins and minerals. And so they're everything. They do everything in your body and they're responsible for how your immune system functions, for example. So if they don't work right, then you're going to have problems. Let me just give you an example of what I'm talking about. There's a really common enzyme called diamine oxidase, it's DAO, and it breaks down histamine in the gut. And its cofactors are zinc and copper and riboflavin, B2. Now, if these nutrients are poorly available in the diet or they're just being used up or there's some kind of deficiency, diamine oxidase isn't going to work right. And you're going to deal with symptoms of histamine intolerance. So that's kind of how you have to understand the background of what enzymes do. Then you can understand what someone like myself does. So now that you understand a little bit about what enzymes are and what they do, you can see how a clinical nutrition doctor. Our tests can really help you find the root cause. So, number one thing to understand is mitochondrial dysfunction is really the root cause of everything, that and oxidative stress, even with chronic UTIs. I say most of the time, though, because there are outliers. There's sometimes people have more of a structural issue that's going on as well, but they're the powerhouse of your cells. So, now that you know that, you can understand like I do the tests that I do include things like, do you want to go through some of the tests that I do?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So, hair tissue mineral analysis, that's hands down my most popular test. And it's basically diagnose assesses the vitamins, not vitamins, the mineral levels and the toxic metals in your hair. And it's non-invasive and it's really insightful. It tells you your deficiencies, your imbalances, your toxic exposure, and also identifies your oxidation rate, which gives you an indication of how well your body is functioning as a whole. Mm-hmm. It means your immune system, your mitochondria, and also your detoxification pathways. Then I do another test called the NutriEval. That's a functional nutritional evaluation that provides insights into your nutritional status, your metabolic function, and then your other imbalances. Or has organic acids, it has amino acids, it has oxidative stress markers, nutrient markers, and then detox indicators. Mm-hmm. I do iodine testing using the 24-hour iodine loading test. I do full comprehensive blood chemistry tests. Like I customize it because I feel like sometimes medical doctors, they run a very basic blood chemistry test that doesn't really tell you a lot of information that you're needing to do. So I've customized my own blood chemistry. I do mycotoxin and toxin testing, blood and urine. And then I do nutrigenomics, which is your genetics. But they're not like your genetics, like your genome, like your hair color or your eye color. It's more about how your enzymes function in certain environments. So it's nutrigenomics. And then I can use that to help me create a nutrition program for someone to help restore homeostasis.
You mentioned that you try and investigate a root cause. Do you look at any other factors, maybe patient symptoms, as well as the root cause to try and determine treatment?
So I found something very interesting in my nutrigenomic testing as I started doing, because I've done hundreds of them, and I found a lot of commonalities. The big one I have found was most of them, about 75%, which is very high, have a polymorphism. So the word polymorphism is kind of like mutation, but not really a mutation, because mutation's negative and polymorphism is not negative. It's just a variation from the wild type, but it's not a bad thing. It's just different. And it functions different in a different environment. So if you ever hear the word mutation and polymorphism, sometimes they're interchangeable, but they're really not the same thing. Mutation is usually based on your actual genome. So anyway, so they have polymorphisms in the NRF2 pathway. So what's NRF2? NRF2, I want you to think of that as like the superhero inside your body. Its main job is to protect damage from harmful chemicals and from stress. So when your cells are stressed, maybe from pollution or UV rays or infection, then NRF2 comes in and springs into action. It's like a switch that turns on certain proteins to shield you. Mm-hmm. Well, interesting, there was an article that was published in 2021 that looked at NRF2 and how it promotes urothelial cell response to bacterial infection by regulating reactive oxygen species. Basically, what they're finding is this NRF2 response element protects the bladder lining when there is an infection. Okay. So generally what happens is there's an infection that comes in a normal person, obviously we have a barrier on our bladder. And I always say to people, you know, because when people blame things for their UTIs, like, oh, it's because of intercourse or this and that, mm-hmm. I have to go back and say, well, then how come babies can sit in diapers all day long with poop and they don't get UTIs? Because they have an immune system and they have the barrier, which is basically kind of the lining of your bladder, has a lot of microbes, it has these chemicals and these signals that helps remove the bacteria out. And then there's this NRF2 that protects the bladder lining when there is an infection so that you're not going to have anything chronic, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, if NRF2 is not working properly, what happens is there's more likely to be catastrophic collateral damage done to the lining of the bladder when there's an infection. So interestingly, what I found is I have patients who have polymorphisms in NRF2. That means they either have one or two copies of, it's not functioning as well. So there's a protein on NRF2 called KEAP1. And I know this gets a little complicated, but this article talks about it too. This journal article was talking about the bacterial invasion and the UTIs. So there's a protein that's attached to NRF2 called KEAP1. And it's like, you can imagine this is NRF2, this is KEAP1, they're attached to each other. And so whenever your body's like, oh, we need a little bit more help, it lets go, KEAP1 lets go of NRF2, NRF2 goes to the cell and does its thing. Mm-hmm. But some people have a polymorphism that makes this attachment strong. It upregulates it. And so it doesn't let it let go. So it's when it's like, oh, there's an infection in the bladder. KEAP1's right here. KEAP1's supposed to let go, but they have an increased expression, which is holding on tighter and not letting NRF2 do its job. And so they're likely to have the damage done to the bladder lining because of the reactive oxygen species that occurs as a result of the infection.
Mm-hmm.
So interesting, as I was doing all my nutrigenomics testing over the last few years, I keep seeing people coming up, including myself, people coming up with keep one upregulation. So I have one or two copies. And so I believe this is a big finding. This is a big finding in this particular, one of the root causes that I think is really contributing to this, because you know that there's people who have UTIs, but they never become chronic, right? Mm-hmm. And then there's people who have UTIs and then it becomes chronic. Well, what makes the difference? I think this is a big part of that. And so I'm able to test that in my nutrigenomics test.
That's really interesting. I'll add the article to the description below so viewers can have a look at that as well. So what is your typical treatment approach when infection is identified?
So the first thing first, I know like a lot of medical doctors like to go immediately treat the infection. And you have to understand that a lot of the patients already have dysbiosis, right? They already have leaky gut. If the people are not familiar with that term, it just means intestinal permeability. And dysbiosis means that they have a bad imbalance of good and bad bacteria in their GI tract. So mm-hmm. when you give an antibiotic, you're making that worse. So I don't like going right to that right away. And besides, that's not even my scope of practice, even though I have a nurse practitioner who can prescribe for me. I try not to, and 90% of the time, I don't even need to, but it's available if I need to. So I do the HTMA first. That's the hair tissue mineral analysis. And right off the bat, we start probiotics, we start gut support, we change the diet immediately. Like that's like the first couple of weeks that they're with me. And then once the results of the test come back for the hair, I actually customize a mineral and vitamin supplement powder. So I compound for each patient. So I don't just give them generic supplements. I give them personalized. So it's personalized nutrition. So your hair test will give you information so that you can get this customized powder based mm-hmm. on your oxidation rate, based on your macro and micro minerals and things like that. And I can check for copper toxicity. I can check for iodine deficiency and thyroid imbalances. And then we do diet makeovers. And right off the bat, we also start a binder. It's called zeolite. It's made from, especially micronized. So it's not necessarily just, it's not only binding. It's actually not really binding. It's actually charging the minerals. It's very, if you're not sure what that means, just check my YouTube because I talk about zeolite in there. A lot of people are not familiar with it, but it's actually charging the minerals, making it more easily, better absorbed in the body. Mm-hmm. So they start right off from the beginning. And I'll be telling you, within a matter of a few weeks, people feel amazing. Just by doing this. So that's why my philosophy is a little different. I don't go right for the infections. I want to see if the immune system can figure it out first, because we have an immune system. We're born with it, right? Yeah. So let's see if we can drive up function, right? Drive up function so our immune system takes care of the job. And then as we're waiting, other test results come back. My NutriVal testing comes back. We tweak the formula of the powder. But there's mold found. We have that discussion about mold. And, you know, sometimes they have to hire somebody to test mold in their home. So they might have to remediate it, blah, blah, blah. And then if after a few months of doing all of this, and that requires their full commitment, that is the thing. This requires commitment. Like, I'm not a magician. I always tell people, I'm not a magician. Like, you've got to do the work, right? Mm-hmm. So if they're fully committed and they've been following this, I usually say within about 3 months or so, 4 months, and they haven't seen any improvements, which is rare. But if it happens, then we go to level 2 testing, which is the MicroGen. We run that, see what's going on in the bladder. And then Ruth Chris has a hypercoagulation panel. She mentors me. So I work with Ruth Chris as well. And she'll review and help guide the next steps. And then I call my nurse practitioner and we'll get them on an antibiotic and biofilm disrupting stuff. And then we'll do some herbals along with it to support the immune system. And just from there, we just continue with test and treat. And a lot of times that just takes care of it. For some patients, I've even had one antibiotic treatment. It was gone. And that's because we did all the work before with the immune system. You see, less yeah. antibiotics are needed because you already started off building up the immune system.
That's really interesting to hear. I've interviewed quite a few clinicians so far, and this is a different approach to what I've heard of before, but it makes sense. Yeah, definitely with the immune system and strengthening that before applying antibiotics.
It also depends on how much pain they're in, because if the pain is severe, sometimes they just need that antibiotic to calm mm-hmm. it down, because it is anti-inflammatory. And it just all, it's, everyone's different. It's a case-by-case situation. It's very, you know, personalized. I haven't needed to do that. I think most patients, when they come to me, they're tired of antibiotics. They don't want antibiotics. So they're coming to me with another solution. So if they're coming to me for that, why am I going to offer that as the first thing? You've already done that. It hasn't worked for you. You're here because you want something different. So that's kind of another thing you have to also keep in mind. Most people who have come to me, they've already been down that road.
So what advice would you give to someone who suspects they have a UTI biotesting negative?
So first things first, if you're feeling like you have a UTI, it could be a biofilm. And a lot of times they're hidden. And so they don't culture out the different technology. The one that I know is MicroGen. So do that, because a lot of times if your culture is negative, this happened to me, then you might actually have a biofilm and eventually it will culture, because that's what happened to me for years and years and years. I was negative, negative, negative. And finally, I think I reached a point where actually I was getting UTIs that were culturing. But when we did the MicroGen, I had like 8 different species of bacteria in my biofilm. 8. Would you believe that? Yeah. Yeah, we worked really hard to get that. Now, I was at a point for myself that it was going on for so long that it was a very complicated biofilm to treat. This is my advice to people. Don't wait to treat it. Don't push it under the rug. You're lucky that the solutions are there for you. When I was diagnosed, you know, over 10 years ago, like 15 years ago now, there was not a lot of options available that are now. So MicroGen was relatively new at that time, and most doctors didn't know what it was. It was Ruth Chris actually treated me, and she was one of the first ones to introduce me to the MicroGen test. So it was relatively new for us, and it wasn't even called MicroGen back then.
Okay, thank you. So how can recurrent and chronic UTI patients reach out to your practice?
So icyhealer.com is my website, and they should book a discovery call. I will mention that we are very selective on patients. I only work with 30 patients a year. I know that sounds a little weird, but it's because I'm high touch and I spend a lot of time with patients. Mm-hmm. And so I like to keep it small and I like to keep it very intimate. I also have a private Facebook group too that all my patients are in to give them additional coaching and support. So we keep it small, 30 a year. And so when they come in, it's kind of like a dual interview. They're interviewing me, I'm interviewing them to see if we're a good fit. And so the way to do that, to come into that interview process, is to go on my website and to book a discovery call.
Okay, amazing. Thank you. Well, thank you, Dr. Mandy, for talking to us today and providing these insights into the treatment of recurrent UTIs. For anyone interested, a link to Dr. Mandy's practice will be added to the description in the video below.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. You're always welcome to reach out to us for more information about clinicians who specialise in recurrent and chronic UTI. Our contact is in the description below. If you'd like to learn more about this or related topics, be sure to check out our other videos or head over to liveutifree.com for other articles on recurrent UTI treatment options. Of course, if you like what we're doing on the channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button here on YouTube and tick the bell so you get notifications about future videos. Thanks so much for joining us for our Clinician Insight series. If you have suggestions for who we should interview next, be sure to drop us a comment.